five fashion designs, each at a special price with any sandwich or salad purchase. But hurry before time runs out.
Jazz caps.
Because jazz caps are the ticket. Get them now at Wendy's.
Jazz caps.
The following is a Kelly Entertainment Company presentation.
It's TV Life. The most information you can get on TV and still have fun. In tonight's other news, the fight is on to clamp down on public enemy number one in Fair Oaks. Then, is high fashion ready for rental maternity clothes? And soaring high above the competition, we found a top-notch Top Gun maintenance crew. Tonight on TV Life. And now, here's your host, Jack Gallagher.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. How are you? Thanks for joining us. You've tuned into TV Light. If you just stumbled across us, just stay right where you are because no harm can come to you. We have a half hour jam-packed with unbelievably witty things that we're going to throw at you. Information, news. What are you smirking about over there? We also have, I think, my best friend in the entire world bringing you the other news. The other news, what is it you say? If you only read the first two pages of the paper, you don't read this stuff. It's true. It's actual. It's happening. We found it. We're bringing it to you. Here's the guy that's going to do it. Phil Cowan, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, Phil. Thank you, Jack. Welcome, gang. At the top of the other news, a massive manhunt is underway in the town of Fair Oaks. Local authorities are trying to get a fix on the suspect's location, but they admit they could be just about anywhere. Stacy Walters has the latest from Fair Oaks.
Sorbet swirled in Breyers vanilla ice cream, new blueberry strawberry sorbets and cream, and new lemon sorbet and cream. Mmm.
The following is a Kelly Entertainment Company presentation.
It's TV Light, the most information you can get on TV and still have fun. In tonight's other news, Robbins and Cowan go to court in the case of the Pomeranian paper. Then, Ellen Emery looks into legislation to provide pensions for some special performers. And, backed by popular demand, a special edition of You May or May Not Be Right, tonight on TV Life. Now, here's your host, Jack Gallagher!
Thank you very much. Oh, stop it, stop it, stop it. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. That's great. That's great. We only have a half hour. Thanks for being here. What a wonderful crowd. We're at the zoo. Yeah. Of course we're at the zoo. Where else are we? We've got a great crowd. We have an unbelievable show for you tonight. Our favorite game show, your favorite game show, You May or May Not Be Right, is back. We have the incredible Dr. Birdbath. And, as always, we're going to start it off with the other news, real, actual events happening around town, around the globe, reported by our favorite other news guy, Phil Cowan, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Jack. Hi, gang, and welcome. At the top of the other news, state lawmakers are taking a look at animal rights, old animal rights. As Ellen Emery reports, there's a measure before the Senate that will provide a comfortable retirement for working animals.
Could be my sister, huh? But
it's your nearest Northern California Chevrolet dealer.
Welcome back to TV Light. We're glad you joined us this evening. We're coming to you from the zoo this evening. We're by the gazelles, and we're around the monkey house. And, you know, it's a special time in the show because it's been away for a while, but we dare not deprive the Sacramento area any longer of its favorite 10-minute game show. It's time for You May or May Not Be Right. I have to get ready for this fabulous event. Steve, take it away.
Thank you, Jack. Not live, but taped from the entertainment capital of North Central California, just up the pike from Turlock. It's Sacramento's most popular 10-minute game show, the all-new You May or May Not Be Right. That's right. It's the game show where you're either right or wrong, depending on how you answer. And now, here's your host, the man with the wildest mane this side of Borneo, Jack Gallagher!
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Oh, it's great to be here at the zoo. It's been so long since I've had this coat on, Steve. It feels good to be back in it.
You look great.
It's a triple knit. Thanks. It's great to be back. We're going to play You May or May Not Be Right. You know how the game is played.
We ask questions. You're either right or wrong, depending on how you answer the questions. It's that simple. And, of course, the team with the most points wins tonight. We're playing an especially exciting round because we have two full teams. Our first team, area radio personalities from, of course, around the Sacramento area. Please welcome, first of all, from KHYO Radio, Kevin Manna, ladies and gentlemen.
You look so lifelike in person.
Thank you very much, Kevin. Ooh, and he touched me, and he's on the radio. From KRAK Radio, please welcome Big Jim Hall, ladies and gentlemen.
Big Jim Hall!
Welcome aboard, Jim.
Thank you.
Big
Thank
Jim.
You. I'm ready.
What a big guy. And, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from KZAP 98 FM Radio, Charlie Weiss, ladies and gentlemen.
Charlie Weiss!
That's good, Charlie. You're ready, man. You're ready. Charlie Weiss, and of course, last but not least, for the radio personality team, from KK105, please welcome the lovely Lisa Kay.
Lisa Kay!
Welcome aboard, Lisa.
I
think you will. Now it's time to introduce our second team. They're comprised of the reporters from the TV Like television program. I got one right in the butt there. Please welcome, first of all, the amazing Paul Robbins, ladies and gentlemen.
Paul Robbins!
Knock me over. Secondly, who do we have? Vic, the lovely and talented. I've got rented lips. Ellen Emery, ladies and gentlemen.
Ellen Emery, ladies and gentlemen.
Looking very safari-ish. Now, please welcome also the lovely and talented Stacy Walters, ladies and gentlemen.
Stacy Walters.
And last, but certainly not least, the man I like to call Steve LaRosa, ladies and gentlemen.
Steve LaRosa!
Now, Steve, I understand for once, everybody crowd around your mic.
Yeah,
you all feel at home, don't you?
Where's the wheel?
Just hang on for 1 second there, Kevin. We're about to get going. Steve, I understand we're playing for quite a valuable prize this evening. Why don't you tell us about it?
We are, Jack?
Yes, we are.
Oh, right you are, Jack. That's right. Well, earlier, we selected two members from our zoo audience, by the way. And I want to introduce them right now. Contestant number one is Pat Coronado of Sacramento. She'll be rooting for the local disc jockeys. Pat! And contestant number two is Sherry Flores of Sacramento. She'll be rooting for the TV Light team.
Stop it now, stop it. And what are they playing for, Steve?
They are playing, Jack. Are you ready for this?
Let me check. Yes.
Tonight's winners will be playing for a flying round trip from Sacramento to Los Angeles. That's right. These two round-trip tickets are compliments of Giselle's Travel and United Airlines, who now serve Los Angeles 5 times daily with connections to the Orient, Hawaii, and the South Pacific. Thanks to Giselle and United. Jack?
Giselle. Yeah. Almost matches, doesn't it? Well, thank you, Steve. Our topic tonight, teams?
Grant's Tomb.
No. Our topic's tonight, animals and the zoo. Animals and the zoo. Are you ready? I'm going to ask you a toss-up question. If you get it right, your team gets to answer a bonus question. Team with the most points at the end of the game wins. Are you ready?
Yeah, ready.
Here's the first question. Keep your finger on the button. First question. Wait till I list all the multiple choices for the first one.
Okay.
The fastest flying animal is A, the falcon, B, the California condor, or C, the Costa Rican cattle bat.
I got it.
It's the disc jockeys, not the TV Light team.
All right. It was the disc jockeys, not the TV Light team.
That's the falcon, Jack.
Absolutely correct.
That's right.
Falcon, by the way, flies at a speed of 217 miles per hour. It is now time. Give yourself a couple of points there, just for
how
being.
Many do you want? How many do we get?
I don't know. Just pick a number and give them to yourselves.
All right. 35.
Good round number, Jack.
35. We'll start with 35. That sounds great. Okay, it's time for your true or false question. You ready?
Yeah,
true
ready.
Or false? A baby giraffe is 6 feet tall at birth.
Oh, it's a TV Light team, not the disc jockeys.
No, I'm sorry, this is just for the disc jockeys, Steve.
Oh,
the TV Light team is cheating.
They buzzed in.
We'd like a question before the end of the show, an answer.
I got the buzzer.
Okay, you did get it.
We knew it!
Yes, true. Absolutely.
Yeah, that's correct.
You're up to 40. Okay, it's time for another toss-up question here. Let me see if I can confuse myself any more than I already have. Here's our second question. This is for both teams now. Keep your fingers on the buzzers. Oh, my goodness.
Great! Run for your lives!
I think this is a case where the introductions took longer than the game to play. We're going to take a short commercial break. We'll be back with our bonus round where everything doubles except point values and prizes. So don't go away because
you may or may not be right.
My kitty cat.
It's at 11. It could save a life.
Sacramento Tata's 10-minute game show, you may or may not be right. And once again, here's your host, Jack Gallagher!
Thank you. Welcome back. Let's take a quick look at the scores. We see that the radio personalities have 40, and the TV Light reporters magically have 35 over the break, ladies and gentlemen.
Amazing.
They're doing incredibly well, and now they've tied the score. Unbelievable. Please flip that back before I have to take physical action. Our next question is a toss-up. Keep your fingers on the buttons. Oh, that feels good. Here we go. The most monogamous animal, that is, the one who's most loyal to its mate, is A, a koala bear, B, an antelope, or C, a gray whale.
It's a TV Light team, not the disc jockey.
It was the TV Light team. Thank you, Steve. TV Light?
Gray.
Not Dakota.
No.
Whale. Say the whale.
Gray
whale,
Jack.
We're sorry, that's far. That's wrong. Would you like to take a stab at that?
I think it was
what were the two?
The remaining choices are antelope or cantaloupe.
Cantaloupe?
And the koala bear.
Koala bear.
Koala bear. Koala bear. That is.
Yeah.
No.
You got it.
Sorry, that's wrong, too.
No. Okay, the other one.
Steve Stizzo got the wrong cards, apparently. The correct answer is antelope, and this is interesting. The antelope never strays more than 16 and a half feet from its mate.
Oh, yeah, I
hear that. Of course, they have that tape measure that's exactly 16 and a half feet long. Here's our next toss-up question. This is for both teams, so keep your fingers on the buttons. Can't feel much better than that. Which of the following is not a food chow made by Purina? Is it A, fly chow, B, monkey chow, C, catfish chow?
It's the disc jockey, not the TV Light
chinchilla
team.
Chow.
Jack, they buzzed in already.
They did. The disc jockey.
Fly chow.
Fly chow is incorrect.
What?
Oh. TV Light team?
Catfish chow.
Also incorrect. Well, we've got a serious bunch of players this evening, don't we, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah. The correct answer?
Yes.
Purina does not make chinchilla chow. Boy, and I felt like Alec Trebek there for a second, didn't I? Chinchilla chow. Okay. Let's move along. Here's our next toss-up questions, and you're doing so poorly that I'm not even going to remind you to put your fingers on the buttons. What meat-eating animal has the longest teeth? Is it A, the Canadian grizzly bear, B, the African lion, C, the Siberian tiger, or D, Marie Osmond?
It's the TV Light team, not the disc jockey.
It was the TV Light team. Can we have an answer, please?
Yes, yes.
We say it's the grizzly bear, Jack.
And you're absolutely incorrect.
Oh.
Let's go to the radio personalities. Your choices are Marie Osmond, the Siberian tiger, or the African lion.
Liberian tiger.
Siberian tiger, absolutely correct. Yeah. Give yourself 5 more points. It's time for your bonus question. This is a true or false question. Listen very carefully because I'm only going to say this once because it's in the contract that I only have to do it once. True or false? In 1 year, an elephant will eat up to 100,000 pounds of hay.
True.
This is
for us.
Have you guys played this game before? Do you hang around this show at all, or what? Is it true or false? Let's not discuss the mathematical possibilities. Let's just say true or false.
Jack would never lie to us. Okay, we say false.
It's absolutely true. 100,000 pounds. Oh, and this is going to get ugly. We have just about a minute left, ladies and gentlemen. We see that the score is 45 radio personalities, 35. We're wrapping it up. We're all out of time, ladies and gentlemen. Unbelievable. Steve, who's our big winner?
We have a winner. That's right. Pat Coronado of Sacramento. You win 2 free round trips to Los Angeles.
We want to thank Kevin Manna, Big Jim Hall, Charlie Weiss, and Lisa Kay for playing with us, and also the TV Light reporters, Steve LaRosa, Stacey Walters, Ellen Emery, Paul Robbins. We're coming back in a second with a man that makes so many animal sounds, you'll wonder if he should be put in a cage. Come back and join us in just a second, ladies and gentlemen.
And remember, TV Light is not a Mark Christian, Bill Putnam production.
Oakwood Lake Resort.
Being here with us tonight. Thanks for bringing Roscoe down. We're totally out of time. Thanks for joining us here tonight. We're going to come back and see you real soon, so tune in again until we see you next time. Have fun. Thanks for watching. So long.
Tomorrow on TV Light, break open your piggy bank and join Steve LaRosa in Canada to shop in the world's largest mall. And what were the private sides of our president's life? find out tomorrow on TV Life. This is not Joey Mitchell. This is Steve Swinkowski, but have a nice night anyway. Northern California's largest Centra dealer.
Be sure to use the freshest ingredients, like some nice day-old sour cream and some crisp vegetables. 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 So.
Skills. One of the first things students learn is how to wear protective equipment. And then there's Physics 101, including Newton's first law of gravity.
And when you get your tree home, make a sharp cut about an inch above the end and then stick it in the water. Don't add any sugar or corn syrup or aspirin or any of that junk. Believe me, good old water is your best beverage for your Christmas tree. This is your red and green grocer with your tip for the day.
Holiday favorite.
What's the deal on this thing here?
It's a man's G-string. He's our Santa Claus.
Uh-huh. With bells, just
with
so
bells,
she knows so you're coming, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Oh. We have the musical
no,
ones.
I didn't mean that. This
and a reporter like me with a good nose for news will soon discover Frederick's scented items.
So happy birthday, Fredericks. The trust of the nation's women is in your hands. That's a big responsibility. So 42 double D. It's a big responsibility. So if trees really do talk to each other, the question is, what do they say? You know, if you're real quiet, you can almost hear them. Shh, listen.
No, you little dog, stay away from me. Stay away, stay away, stay away. Bad doggy, bad doggy. Shh, shoo, shoo. Good, good, good dog, good dog, good dog.
Meanwhile, at the nation's nurseries, the cries of millions upon millions of destitute trees fall on deaf ears.
It's here that competition is fierce among lonely trees hoping to be adopted and taken home by some caring tree lover.
Take me, take me, take me, please, take me.
Losing leaves must be a hot topic of conversation among trees. I mean, they lose all their leaves just before the coldest time of the year, just when they need all that protection the most. How would you like it if you lost all your hair just before Christmas time? Let me show you the bathroom. You're gonna like this. Isn't this quaint? Isn't this charming? Old world?
There's real danger here in the bathroom, folks, if you haven't noticed. Excuse me, could I get by here,
right.
Please? It's right over here, over at the faucet. It's something we call the double faucet dance. Let me show you here. Hot. Cold. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
That's the sound of the
man
working on a train.
Ooh.
Dang.
Ooh.
That's the sound of the man working on the train. Dang. All day long they're singing.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh.
You know, you are now responsible for the phone lines within your home. And there are demons inside the walls of your home. Demons ready to pounce. Demons ready to make your phone life a living heck. So, let's say the wiring does go bad. What are you gonna do? Well, you got three options.
You can fix it yourself, or you can call an electrician.
Hello, is this Larry the electrician magician?
Or you can call the phone company.
Think taste best. Now, sure, the sugar may rot your teeth and the sodium might cause high blood pressure, but hey, it's only cereal. What's the worst that could happen?
Assuming they'll give you that kind of freedom. You put, did I hit on something touchy here?
No. We all have spacious accommodations here at TV Light.
But what you could do is take a little bit of that particular color that inspires you and you particularly need for, say, creativity or a little mental clarity. All right,
my toes are soaked, my shorts are soaked, everything's soaked. I'm
Steve.
Jack? Jack,
yeah.
Where are you?
I'm here, Steve.
Where, Jack? Where are you? Are you there?
Yes, can you hear me?
When it's raining, and you can see that the rain is beating down on us very heavily right now, when it is raining, this kind of affects the snakes, doesn't it?
Not really. Number one is the snakes that are in the building are comfortable, and the snakes that are out here are right now dormant. So they're hibernating. But you know something?
What?
You're a python's delight.
So, Bill, what you're saying is that the rain does not affect the
snakes? It doesn't affect the snakes at all. Not at all. No. They're a different, unique animal. Not at all.
So there's no story here, huh?
No story here.
Do snakes swim, Bill?
Oh, yeah, they can swim. Okay. But it's not their delight.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks, Bill.
You're welcome.
Well, you know, these are the kind of live shots that remind me of my days as a cub reporter back in Pennsylvania, Jack.
Yeah, that's very interesting, Steve. We really don't have time for that now. We'll get back to Steve later. I've heard that story, and it's pretty interesting. Now, there's
to be up one night and maybe down another.
Just a second, Gary. You've got a mosquito on you. Jeez.
Oh, I want to thank you.
Yeah, that's
good. We, you know, we had to back and win some ball games.
Season's not over yet.
Certainly
absolutely not. Thanks for joining us, Gary. We'll be listening for you. Of course, our other reporter is here, Ellen Emery, and I'm going to toss it to Ellen right now. Ellen?
Thank you, Steve. I'm here with my first basketball player.
How about moving the Kings down here? Sure, it's not as spacious as the current arena, but in here, every seat's a good one.
Front row.
Benji, you bum!
And the price tag here.
$12 million?
Think of what you could buy the city for $12 million.
I've been sitting here doing this news the whole time, and I can't help but notice that our own Steve Swinkowski, usually pretty chipper guy, is all alone by himself up in the bleachers. And Steve, what's happening, man?
Well, the family read the review and they didn't come.
But they were all supposed to be here?
Yeah, all 28 of them.
Steve, it's no big deal, man. It's the first day. What do they know? It's a good show. We'll do better. We really will. Don't be down. Come on, come on. We can't stand this. Just keep repeating to yourself, it's only the critics. It's only the critics.
It's only the critics. It's only the critics.
That's right. We'll be back in a minute with more TV Light. Hang around.
That's what we like to call our no kidding information. Hey, did you know that America's Cup is bottomless?
No kidding.
No.
Another fun fact from your friends here at TV Light.
No kidding.
No.
Holy shit.
Scalpel.
Every move you make.
Sponge.
Every bond you break. Every step you take. I'll be watching you.
Police tape.
Every
Howard Klein is one doctor who never operates without his trusty boombox nearby.
Do you think it affects your performance?
I think it affects my mood, which might affect my performance.
Right. So if I'm going and having some surgery by you, I better make sure you got your music on.
I would definitely check to see what the selections would be for that day.
But music in the OR is more than just a soundtrack for skilled surgery. Patients actually benefit from the tunes.
Were you nervous going into the operation?
A little bit. I think everybody is always a little nervous. Okay. And music really helped calm me down.
Two recent studies on patients requiring local or regional anesthesia actually show that soothing melodies reduced heart rates and blood pressure. In fact, only half the normal sedatives were needed to keep patients calm.
One researcher rated music's effectiveness equal to about 2.5 milligrams of Valium. But most doctors agree it's impossible to gauge because everyone has their own taste in music.
Well, I think if it's real boring music, it can put you to sleep real fast. But I think that it, I don't know if I can quantitate it as the amount of drugs used. I like the classical stations and music. The trouble is when the overture of 1812 comes on and the cannon shot goes off at a crucial moment in the surgery, that can sometimes be disturbing.
And then when everything has gone well and we're closing and feeling good about everything, I like to put on a little ZZ Top.
Oh, good. Why?
It makes me feel like I'm moving down the road toward the next case of the day.
TV Light, I'm Steve Swinkowski.
And when you get your mountain lion home and you're preparing it for dinner, please use some spices and some brandy and some nice fresh vegetables. Vegetables. Quite frankly, folks, mountain lion tastes an awful lot like bald eagle, which is another delicious dish, but it's getting increasingly harder and harder to find. This is your wild game grocer with your tip for the day. This is your blue chip grocer with your tip for the day. This is your red and green grocer with your tip for the day.
Stephanie,
I'll bet me tomorrow. Maybe I can find.
About a film that the theme song, you can hardly even sing it. You know, once you get past the first couple of words. And if you've had that problem, not to fret, my friends. All this will be cleared up for you when you see this story by Steve LaRosa.
Sing Victoria. No.
Well, I think we've proven unequivocally that most Americans cannot sing this song. Mr. Steve Stizzo. Next item on the agenda, what does this song mean? Well, we're going to give you the English translation, and what better way than through the song stylings of the Velvet Hammer himself, Mr. Jack Gallagher.
To dance the bamba. Dance the bamba is necessary to have some grace. A bit of grace for me, for you. Hey, get on up. Hey, get on up. I'd be for you. I'd be for you. Hey, I'm no sailor. Hey, I'm no sailor. I'm the captain. Hey, I'm no sailor. Why, captain? Gotta take it home, Steve. Bye, bye, Mama.
Now, wasn't that incredible? Now, we're not only gonna teach you the song, we're gonna teach you the dance. This is La Bamba with Eric and Sonia.
Sir,
when you go see the movie, now you can sing along, you can dance along. Don't thank us. We're happy to bring it to you. It's another public service from the people at TV Light. I'm Steve LaRosa.
Thank you, Steve. And we have got a Friday night crowd here, and we have a great half hour of TV Light for you tonight. And we're live. We're coming to you live from right here at 3 Television Circle. We're on the 12th floor, looking over the beautiful railroad tracks. It's just gorgeous. If you haven't seen it, I really can't do it justice with an explanation. But we have a great show. We have a good buddy of mine from my my Boston days, Bobby Goldthwait, is with us here tonight. And we're going to be talking with him a little later on. You might know Bobby from the movie Burglar with Whoopi Goldberg. He's done HBO specials. He's was in One Crazy Summer. He's done 3 or 4 or 5 different movies. But we're going to have a good time. We're going to start it off right away with the other news the way we always do every night. And the guy that brings it to you like nobody else can, please welcome Phil Cowan, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Jack. Welcome, gang, and good evening. At the top of the other news, a big win for Dynasty star Joan Collins. A judge ruled late today that Collins' prenuptial agreement with estranged husband Peter Holm was valid, and the former Swedish pop singer deserves no more of the actress's money. So the often bitter trial has come to an end, and it's a good thing, too, for as Steve Swinkowski tells us, he thought this was going to go on forever.
Someone to hold his placards while he holds up his pants. July 21st, Joan Collins tells a judge her prenuptial agreement with Holm is more than just a piece of paper.
That this is the most important issue in my whole life.
Yes, but poor Peter, he needs that $80,000 a month in spousal support. Excuse me, I need a tissue.
July 23rd, aspiring actress Romina Danielson testifies she had several sexual encounters with Holm, and he called her his passion flower. Danielson then faints on the witness stand and is later carried from the courtroom. So, what's next? Will Peter Holm lose his pants? Is Joan Collins planning more courtroom surprises?
You bet I am.
And will Romina Danielson's theatrics land her a role on Dynasty? For the answers to these and other questions, don't miss the next exciting episode of As the Girl Churns. For TV Light, I'm Steve Swinkowski.
Hi, Steven. In other news, a demand for equal time. Last night on TV...
You have till Monday, 9 p.m. But hurry, or the Lazy Boy you want might be gone. Hurry in now to your nearby Lazy Boy Showcase shop.
Welcome back, and glad you're with us. We're coming to you live tonight, and it's a real pleasure for me to have my next guest here. We met each other about 6 or 7 years ago when we were doing the comedy clubs in New England, and since then he's gone on to star in 3 or 4 movies, the latest one being Burglar with Whoopi Goldberg, and we were lucky enough to get him before he appears on David Letterman next week and starts his national tour the week after that. Please welcome my good buddy Bobcat Goldthwait. Go ahead. You gotta have that. You gotta have the big flag, the big white flag. And...
Thank you very much. It's a big thrill to be back here again with you, Jack.
Well, you know, we got kind of tired of you calling and saying, "Can I get back on the show? Can I get back on the show?"
So, well, I appreciate you having me on the show.
Anytime, you know. We have this co-host thing that's opening up.
Really?
Just give it some thought. Don't answer now.
Like me, like, I'll be like your man of white.
Exactly.
But they might find, like, some Playboy photos of me or something.
I think I have, though. I think I have the
negative. I got a picture of you butt naked. You know?
Okay, let's change the subject.
No, I wanted to talk about it. In fact, I have those pictures.
I think we have them in the control room. Can we pop those up? So it's great to see you. Your wife is here with you, and your little baby is here.
What a
doll.
Yeah,
she's beautiful.
Cute. Yeah, well, thank God she didn't come out like me, you know? I don't know.
So what do you think about being a dad?
Pretty weird, you know? I mean, I don't know. See, I'm not going to age gracefully. Having me for a father is like having Curly as a dad. You know? She'll be like, when I'm 13 or 14, I'll be going, how come your friends never come in the house? How come they always pick you up at the end of the driveway? What are you, embarrassed of the old man? I'll tell you, that acting crazy, that paid for your braces. Get in the house, we're gonna watch Police Academy 50 again. Police Lobotomy, Police Lobotomy 4 was out.
Yeah.
I think it like opened up at the video stores. I think they passed the theater and just rolled.
But you see, 1, 2, and 3 people were going, but 4 came out and I heard people going, ah, now I see.
Yeah, now it makes sense.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sitting there in the movie theater, right? I've got the script of the thing and I couldn't even follow it. I'm like, oh. You know, we had to make a Police Academy 4. There were so many unanswered questions for 2 and 3.
Yeah, it's the truth. It really is the truth.
And I did need that extension on my house pretty badly.
It's the hope of Villa da Academy. Now, what about the latest one? You just finished a movie. When's that going to come out?
Oh.
With the, what's the name of that?
Hot to Trot.
Hot to Trot, with the horse. How'd you like working with the horse?
It's a talking horse movie.
Yeah.
For those that... how do I like talking to, I don't know, this big 1,100-pound diseased animal breathing horse breath in my face? Yeah, it was a dream come true. You can really riff with a horse, you know? You start ad-libbing and this thing going, dah. But the horse wouldn't look at me, so they would put another horse behind me at all times. So he'd be like going, hey, how you doing? It's kind of like talking to my agent, you know?
Kind of looking past you.
Yeah. Hello, introduce me. I guess heaven sprung a leak. How's my name?
We're going to take a break, and we're going to come back in like 2 minutes, and then it's time to yak with Jack and the cat. Stick around. We're coming back.
At last, Oldsmobile quality.
Back again. It's the Babs and Betty Show, and we want to tell you that if you'd like to come down and visit, you can call and get tickets. Here's the number right on your screen, 325-3285. Call it now and say, I want tickets, and I want them bad. And I just...
You got like this thing in your ear.
Jeez, it's gone now.
It's like a piece of cheese or something.
Now, look at us on the monitor. We belong together, man.
Yeah, this is such natural colors.
We got a... it's time...
Before, after.
It's time for us to do section 4, and tonight we're going to do
Jack Elliott's Home Yuppie.
Let me get to this. We're going to take some phone calls tonight. It's Yak with Jack and the Cat.
Jack, I think I'm bleeding internally.
I think that's been happening for years. Look, we've only got 4 minutes left. Let's take a call. Hi.
Hi, Jack.
Hi. Who's
Hi.
This? Who is this? Who's
it's
this?
Jerry.
What's your name?
Jerry.
Jerry. And where are you calling from, Jerry?
Concord.
Concord. How are you?
Fine.
Good. You have a question tonight?
Uh-huh. I'd like to ask Bobcat if this is a chance for his trial run as being guest host of this show, and then will it spin off into another show? Like maybe he can become the real host of The Late Show on Fox?
Ooh.
You know?
Ooh.
Yeah. You mean like how the Jeffersons took off from All in the Family?
I think that's exactly what you mean.
So I have to talk to my manager, Reuben Kincaid, you know, relax, we'll work it all out.
I don't know if you want to give that information away, too, about that whole, well, we better not even mention that.
What do you mean?
Yeah, you know what I mean.
Me hosting The Late Show?
Yeah, that'll work out. We got another caller on the line there.
Hi. Is our next sniper there?
Hello?
Hi.
Who's this?
Mary.
Mary?
Hi, Mary, how are you doing?
All right.
She's using the phone, Bob. She's using the phone. She's
Mary,
not the
can
screen.
You hear us?
I can hear you fine.
Is the caller there?
How to turn down a radio.
Turn on your radio.
Do you have a question, Mary? Comment?
Yes. I'd like to know, why don't you show the band more? You used to do the high five with Steve Stizzo, and now you've kind of faded away from the band.
Do you know what the problem was? We haven't faded away with the band. We have the best band in television.
I agree.
The problem we were having was that I'd come out and give Steve the high five, but because I took the Bob Goldthwait self-defense course, one day I came out, I gave him the high five, crushed all of his fingers. Thanks for calling, Mary.
Nice, thank you. It was such a pleasure.
That's very nice. That's
but how do you son Jesus for me?
There we go. And we have another caller on the line.
I mean, wasn't that Mary?
No, I don't think so, Bob.
I think this will be the last time I'll be online.
I think maybe it is. Kind of like a swan thing.
Bye. I talked to you. I think we're just hanging out.
We have another call. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, who's this?
It's Lisa.
Bob, the chicks are calling.
Man, I'm spraying my musk or something through Sacramento. Ladies, the fun stops here.
Oh.
The Elgato is married.
What? My heart's crumbling.
Can I help you, Lisa?
Hey, Bobcat, were you on Dweezil Zappa's album on I Want a New Yacht? Or I Want a Yacht?
Yeah, that was me.
Who's and that? What was that?
I was on Dweezil Zappa's album.
Oh, okay.
I just want to say that I love you, and I think you're totally cool, you know, like, as a comedian. And, yeah, I was wondering how that.
Yeah, well, I just want to say that's real nice, but I don't know you. I mean, I'm flattered when someone says they love me, but isn't that kind of strong? You know, I never had a groupie when I bagged groceries for a living.
Oh, you did. I think they were just a little too shy.
Freezer wrap me next.
They'd say, in the way he puts those avocados in
that
the bag.
They make a lot of sense.
They sure do, and that means that the windmill's wrapping up, and we're totally out of time. Thanks for being here. Nice having you guys. See you on Monday night. Until then, have fun over the weekend. See you later.
Monday night on TV Live, Province and Cow get much-needed help in updating their wardrobe. And we'll show you how you can eat junk food and live longer. Monday on TV Live. This is Joey Mitchell.
For our first forecast, I can't believe how warm it is outside.
Yeah, but it's going to get colder, isn't that correct?
That's right.
You took the thunder away.
You've been looking at the progs, as they say. Yeah, let's take a look at the current shot from Sky High 13, shall we? 59 degrees right now. The sun was just peeking out about 15, 20 minutes ago, but we have mostly cloudy skies. Here's what's happening. Not one, but two low-pressure systems approaching us. And that warm front that's splitting through the state is really causing a difference in temperatures. 42 degrees at Mason City, while at the same time it was 63 at Lamoni. And at the same time, 36 behind the cold front at North Platte, with some showers there. And in fact, that's what we have for our forecast this evening. A lot of clouds and a possibility of some showers. Look for a low around 38. We'll take a look at tomorrow's forecast coming up soon right here on Live at 5.
All right, Stephen, thank you.
Want to find out what's hopping at the Sports and Vacation Show?
Or what's bouncing?
Oh, look at this, Stephen. Whoa. Well, we got tomorrow's forecast coming up right here on Live at 5. Whoa.
Double whammy of sunshine, let's pull him out. A triple whammy of sunshine, the first. Come back here, where are you? Why, you. Where'd he go?
You all weird.
Tomorrow's map, please.
Well, it is definitely short-sleeve weather out at Sailorville Lake, where our Steve Swankowski is having a little drink there, huh, Steve?
Well, it's a little visual aid, okay? We've been talking about how low we've been as far as precipitation. Now, usually by the first week of May, we've had about 8 inches of precipitation. Now, this is about 8 inches of pop here, okay? Now, I'll show you exactly where we are by drinking some of this pop. Here goes.
This has got to hurt, Steve. Ouch, that had to burn. He's not done yet. How about a musical interlude? Is that about right?
Does the foam count?
Excluding the bubbles, that's about how much we've had so far this year in comparison to how much we should have had. About 2.5 inches of rain so far this year, and we're about 5.5 inches short. So we need some good rain, and we need it in a hurry. But it kind of gives me a sick feeling just to think about it, you know? Let's take a look at what's happening. Here are the current conditions. We have a temperature of 83 degrees, nice sunny skies. Winds are still out of the north, but they will shift and come from the south very shortly. Barometer is falling at this hour. We take a look at a jet stream depiction for you. This is why we're having the warm weather. We've got a big upper-level low-pressure system off the west, a big upper-level low off the east. We've got rain on both coasts, but we're getting warm air being pulled up from the southwest, and we're going to have above-normal temperatures for at least the next 5 days or so. Here's your forecast for tonight. Clear skies, winds out of the south, low down around 54. For tomorrow, clear to partly cloudy, winds out of the south and gusty, and a high around 85. And we are saluting a senior this evening. She is 103 years young. Her name is Grace Deal. She's of Green. She's living at the Mathers Nursing Home up there. And she is an aunt of the famous Barbara Walters. So we wish continued good health to Grace Deal.
You know, it would take me half an hour to drink that much soda.
It's going to take me that long to digest it.
Steve, thank you very much.
Right.
As we told
Blake Edwards with strong supporting performances from Malcolm McDowell and Mariel Hemingway, I strongly recommend Sunset, but I cannot recommend the new Robert Duvall, Sean Penn film, Colors. Tune in Saturday at 10 and watch me rip that to shreds. I'm Steve Swinkowski.
I meant to kill you.
This is a complicated film. Perhaps confused is a better word. Sometimes it looks like a Norman Rockwell painting brought to life. Other times it's more like a suspense thriller about a crazed psychopath. It's a story of love. It's a chronicle of revenge. It's an epic drama. It's a pain in the neck. Still, it was worth it just to see the evil side of William Hurt. So I called New World Pictures in Los Angeles and requested some clips. And they put me in touch with a PR guy in Milwaukee. He said New World was no longer enthusiastic about promoting 18 again, and he had no more clips to send. But I said, I want to help you sell this movie. Didn't matter. So I have no clips to show you. I don't even have a press kit. Just about the only thing I can do is act out a scene for you. In this scene, the soul of Jack Watson, played by George Burns, decides to tell his friend, played by Red Buttons, that he's actually standing right in front of him in the body of his 18-year-old grandson, David, played by Charlie Schlatter. Okay, you got that? It's Red Buttons talking to the body of Charlie Schlatter, which now houses the soul of his grandfather, played by George Burns. Jack, is it really you? Yes, Charlie, it's me, Jack. I'm now in David's body. No, I don't believe it. Charlie, I'll prove it to you. Would David know about the time we were snowed in for a full week with that all-girls choir back in 32? Jack, it is you! Oh, it's George Burns with a cigar. Anyway, this is a
Wanowski family from Troop here in Disney World. They were also winners in the Pride of Pennsylvania poster sweepstakes, and we'll talk to them tomorrow. Tonight at 11 on the late edition, we'll be talking to some vacationers here in Orlando. It seems many people have been saving money by using the family car instead of flying to their vacation destination. So we'll talk about that tonight at 11, and I'll see you again live tomorrow at 6 via satellite from Disney World's Magic Kingdom and Epcot Center. Deb, Gary.
Great, Steve.
How are the families holding?
Well, storm. It'll come spinning into the Gulf Coast area. And in fact, probably by Thursday, it will be a hurricane. So we're going to be watching that guy. I doubt he's going to cause any problems for us. Today, we're not going to have a whammy of sunshine, but a whammy of thunderstorms. Boom, boom. Okay. So a twister day in Nebraska. A couple of injuries from that as this warm front moves through. And you're watching News 22. My, what good taste you have. Map. Clouds for us. I said, clouds for us.
Something's stuck up there. Let me see if I can.
I feel like Fonzie with a jukebox. That frontal system is, we got to get some new equipment. That frontal system is.
That downtown is looking great.
He's trying to get.
You know, we had a
fly. Summer fly in the studio. Yeah. Do you know how?
Satellite shot. Still clear. Clear. Got a frog in my throat. Maybe we can get the frog to get the fly. Yeah.
Clear skies over the Commonwealth, but some clouds moving through.
Well, oh my. Well, let's see if we can drive down the highway here. Here we go. Boop, 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 boop. Yeah, you. It's a mess.
You've got a scratchy throat. Yeah. What we're talking about. There's a little itching there.
It's that time of year.
Yeah, it is.
Jim's got it. I've got it.
Jim has it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. Jim held out like a professional.
Pressure's on. Here I am, folks. Feeling good. Yeah. Hi. Let's take a look at the old map, huh? Okay. Meet
Commissioner Uberoth will decide what's to become of Necro, but as our Steve Swinkowski reminds us, it's not a crime to doctor the baseball, only to get caught doing it.
The umpires are right there as Joe Necro tries to fling his Emery board out of his pocket and out of sight. Necro obviously knows nothing about sleight of hand because he created no diversion.
Now, this is what I would have done. Cameraman Eddie Maloof is going to play the part of the umpire accusing me of scuffing the ball.
You're scuffing the ball, Steve.
Says who?
Says me.
Am not.
R2.
Am not.
R2.
Now, at this point, I create a diversion. Hey, isn't that Vanna White over there in the stands?
I don't see anybody, Steve.
Yeah, she's over there somewhere. Keep looking.
I don't see it.
I might be wrong. So, where were we?
R2.
Am not.
R2.
Am not.
R2.
Am not. Now, very few of us get to use the scuff technique because very few of us throw baseballs for fun. But there are a couple of things you can do to get the upper hand in your favorite sport. Let's take golf, for instance. When you're approaching your opponent's ball, make sure he's not looking and then place your foot on top of it and step with all your weight. This should effectively change the lie of his ball in your favor. Tough cheese, pal.
Here's a bowling tip. Every bowler needs a nice, smooth, slippery alley for proper approach and release of the ball.
Now, a sticky substance like this spray adhesive, applied in just the right spot in the alley, should effectively upset the natural rhythm of your opponent's game. Let's watch. For my money, that's better than a scuff ball. For TV Light, I'm Steve Swinkowski.
Thank you, Steve.
Let's see. The Lumberjacks from the Shears Lumberjack Show of Champions. You knew you were going in. I saw you look in Dave's eyes and you said, you got me.
Well, I suspected, you see, but it was all drama. I mean, it's just television drama. You know, I could stay out there as long as I want, which is indicative of how easy it is, Steve. And that's why we want you to come on out. Being a weatherman, we figure that you could weather the log rolling.
I get
and
it.
Just give all your viewers in Des Moines.
But I'm going to get on there and I'm going to hurt myself.
No, I guarantee you that you cannot be hurt. Just your ego, possibly your makeup, maybe your shoes. We can take those off.
All right.
Okay, Des Moines, look quick.
What?
Tell the viewers how easy it is.
Easy as pie.
Your arm is 6 inches taller than my arm.
I really shouldn't do this, you know, but...
You shouldn't do this?
No, it's, you know, what if the guy's, West Coast champion or something?
Do I look like the West Coast champion?
No.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, okay, right, go.
1, 2, 3.
Go.
Oh, there's no way. I can't even get any leverage on that guy.
Just tell me when you start.
I'm trying now.
Tell me when you start.
Tim Hedrick picked a great day to be off today. Mm-hmm.
Picked a great weekend. I have a great week to be off.
The whole week?
Yes.
You're going to be with us all week?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Sorry. Let's take a look at the high temperatures today. Boy, it was a warm one. A good 25 degrees above normal across the state. 81 in Des Moines, or 82 in Des Moines, 81 in Ames. 71 at Spencer, Mason City with a 76. The 81 at Waterloo was just 1 degree shy of a new record there. And the 83 at Ottumwa was about 2 degrees shy of a new record there. And temperatures across the nation today were very warm. In fact, the eastern two-thirds of the nation saw temperatures above normal, with 60s reaching as far north as Manitoba, and then across the St. Lawrence at Quebec, upstate New York, and New Hampshire and Vermont. They saw temperatures in the 60s. It's very unusual for those folks. Tomorrow, the temperatures won't be quite as warm, so enjoy it. while it lasts. Okay, here's what we have right now. Temperature 64 degrees. Skies are partly cloudy. Winds are out of the southwest at 8 miles an hour. Humidity at 56%, relatively speaking. Dew points at 48. The barometer 29.69, rather low, but it will rise during the next couple of hours as we have a rather wimpy high pressure system moving on in. All right, here's the current satellite picture. You can see scattered clouds over the state, mostly upper level stuff. And where high pressure is sitting, coming now down just east of the Rockies, there's a lot of cloudiness. Why is that? That's because of an upper level disturbance, and that.
Regrets about this month.